Hey everybody, this is Anthony Bowe with The Shop Magazine. I'm here at the SEMA show, and the following video is brought to you by Alliant Insurance Services. They offer packages that will lower your shop risk and your cost of insurance. Right now, I am with Stuart Gosswein of SEMA Federal Government Affairs, and we're going to talk about the tariffs right now and get an update directly from SEMA. So, Stuart, where are we at right now in this tariff situation?
Hey, Anthony. There's actually three tariffs that are being imposed or potentially imposed. So we've got the metals, steel, and aluminum. Steel at 25% and aluminum 10% as global. So there's a few countries that have negotiated quotas, but otherwise, if you're importing steel as a raw material or aluminum from any of those countries, you're subject to tariffs. And then the big one is China. And so we've had a couple of different lists for China. The first one was $50 billion worth of products being imported, and we're up to the second list of $200 billion at 10%, and there's an awful lot of auto parts that are on there. And the third list is basically everything else, $267 billion, and as of December, that might take effect. And so our message for SEMA is that our companies did not have this in their business plans. And the premise is that the tariffs will bring the trading partners to the bargaining table to deal with unfair trade or too much trade going one direction. We're not seeing that at the moment. We're just seeing tariffs being imposed on American companies and American consumers. Tariffs are a form of taxes.
What are some of the tangible effects we're seeing in the market right now due to the tariffs?
They're hurting a lot of companies, and so they have to make decisions as to whether they're going to be able to absorb the tariffs or whether they pass them on to the consumers. And then the big question is, how long is this going to last? And there is no answer to that.
How does SEMA expect the situation to change in the next year, if at all?
That's a great question. We don't have the answer. So one of the points that we make is that the president is using a couple of tools at his disposal under trade law to unilaterally impose the tariffs. And so Congress is actually shut out of the process. The president can say that this is a national security threat, which he did with steel and aluminum, or that he has the right to go after China for unfair trade balances and intellectual property theft. But meanwhile, it's the president that decides yes or no whether the tariffs are going to stop. His premise is we're going to bring people to the trading table and negotiate new trade agreements. We're not seeing that.
What can our readers do to get their voices heard on this matter?
Great question. So go ahead and be vocal and let your members of Congress know what your stand is. Tell them that they have to be engaged. There are tools that they can take advantage of to go back to the president and say, you're misusing this as a, for example, national security argument, and go ahead and write the White House and say, we don't like this.
Great. Is there anything else you'd like to mention on this topic or anything else?
Really appreciate the opportunity to get the message out. So SEMA agrees that there are unfair trade practices out there and there is intellectual property theft taking place. So we're pleased to be that someone is taking up that battle. But meanwhile, this is the wrong way to go about it.
Great. Well, Stuart, thank you so much for joining me. I really appreciate your time.
Thank you, Anthony.
All righty.